So I'm Kevin Natigechi from the Limos Lab, and I'm going to talk about proof of behavior. It's a preliminary work in collaboration with Paul-Marie Goldmund from the LMBP, Pascal Lafourcade from the Limos, and Ariane Tichy from the CERDI. So for the outline plan, I will start by a short introduction. I will recall well-known things about Bitcoin. Then I will talk about related works before introducing a new notion of a proof of behaviors and a new cryptocurrency that builds upon it before concluding. So in Bitcoin, we have a pool of miners that need to solve a complex cryptographic puzzle to create the new block and get rewarded. So this cryptographic puzzle consists in finding an ounce and such that the hash function applied to the hash of the last block, the block of transactions, and the ounce returns a hash value that is lower than a given threshold. And finding this ounce is highly computation intensive task, and but at the contrary, verifying it is easy. So the first major problem of this proof of work is that the overall Bitcoin mining consumes much more energy than some countries. For instance, we see that Bitcoin consumes more than Switzerland. Besides, the computations done for constructing this proof serve no purposes. So besides these drawbacks, we have the Bitcoin blockchain that has proven to be useful to keep tracks of transactions. And we have a lot of applications that rely on blockchains like identity management, document certification and tracking, online e-voting and e-auction. And since Bitcoin, we have a lot of cryptocurrencies like Ethereum, Bitcoin, Dogecoin, Ripple, to name just a few, which are classified in four categories. We have scam, which are designed quickly and are not secure. Their only goal is to convince people to invest money in them. We have the clones of Bitcoin or Ethereum, which are dedicated to some special purposes, like, for instance, poker coin for playing poker. We have some coins like prime coins, cure coins, folding coin, which have a proof of work aiming at serving a new useful goals, for instance, for solving medicine or mathematical problems. And some of them rely on a new paradigm for establishing the consensus. For instance, proof of stake, proof of space, proof of reachability, or proof of elapsed time. Voilà. So our aim is to propose a new cryptocurrency, ICOMO Bitcoin, based on a new consensus algorithm that serves a new goal. The incentivization of green behaviors in terms of mobility. So the closest related projects are SolarCoin, whose aim is to reward the producers of solar electricity at a rate of one SolarCoin per megawatt hour of solar energy. And we have MobiCoin, a project of cryptocurrency presented by Mercedes-Benz in 2018. Whose goal is to collect users' data and reward with MobiCoin the drivers that have an ecological drive. So unfortunately, today MobiCoin is not yet used and there is a lack of information about its status. So the aim of ICOMO Bitcoin is different since we reward both collaborative mobility and zero emission mobility like walking and biking. Here we have graphical representations that ranks the personal transportation modes by increasing the order of greenhouse gas emissions. And this gives us insights in how proportionally should the individuals be rewarded. with us introduced the notion of proof of behavior, where instead of proving that we perform computational intensive tasks, we have to prove that we do positive actions in the real world. And these positive actions then enable the generation of coins. So there are several advantages to replace proof of work by a proof of behavior. No specialized hardware like ASICs or GPU are required for mining. Anyone can select the green behavior she wants to conform to generate coins, and there is no waste of energy. So as Bitcoin, Ecobee Bitcoin is decentralized and everything is written and publicly available. So in the POB, in the proof of behavior paradigm, the right to write in the blockchain is not given to the miners that have a lot of computational powers as in Bitcoin, but it is in fact shared between several actors, the user, the prover, the verifier. So the user who performs transactions like buying food or any object, the prover who realizes a proof of behavior, for instance, by walking or biking, the verifier who verifies the validity of proof of behaviors and the validity of transactions. So in fact, once they are verified, the POB and transactions are written in the blockchain. And the first application of a proof of behaviors is the design of a cryptocurrency that incentivizes less emission in the transportation by rewarding transport modes like walking or biking. And for these two modes, proof of behavior is in fact a real GPS trace that is collected and signed by a simple smartphone. The signature is in fact necessary to prove that the smartphone was not involved in several traces at the same time. And for other behaviors like the use of public transportation or carpooling, we have several GPS traces that need to be collected and compared to check they're actually similar. So to conclude, proof of behaviors is a nice paradigm to incentivize green behaviors and promote sustainable mobility. As for the proof of work, we have many proof of behavior based applications that can be considered. But to concretize EcoMobicon, several requirements need to be addressed. We need, for instance, the development of an efficient pattern recognition algorithm to accurately recognize transport modes, as well as a cryptographic algorithm for ensuring the privacy of the individuals in compliance with the GDPR. Thanks for your attention.